Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you and welcome, and thank you to the Strand Wonderful Theater to host us, and thank you for the Bluebillies bringing us all together.
Looking forward to this evening.
My name is Mark Mauzert. I will be your host tonight. I'll introduce the bands as they come to the stage. Hopefully I won't mispronounce too many names, but I'll try. And I want to just start out by telling you, you got a fantastic show, of course, with the Bluebillies. They always want to say Bluebellies. Kevin Harder, who's a returner to the show here, and Sugar in the Tree, and Wharton and Company. So a whole heck of a lot of entertainment. Somewhere along the line, I'm going to sprinkle in some poetic parlance. I make part of my living as a cowboy poet, which means I broke so many bones I can't cowboy. So I got to write about it. And we'll start out with a little one that I call As Would the King. He drives the wagon down Main Street. Jingling bells decorate the team. From atop his bouncing seat, he maneuvers to fulfill his scheme. The buckboard painted festive, Christmas red and green, people stop and stare, loaded with presents, tied with ribbons of silver sheen, pulled by Belgian bear. This day marks 930 year, hauling gift to extol Christ's birth, just as Grandpa did when town was frontier, ushering jubilation, peace, and mirth. Not a rich man, nor a 501c, pockets not deep, he of little means, but spreading joy through his giving spree, akin St. Nick, but wearing jeans. To the shelter, sacks of socks and underwear, some turkeys for the needy at Grace Church. The post, where toys for tots are gathered with care, none left behind meets none left in the lurch. Sausage, gravy, and biscuits for the veteran's breakfast, a tree for the senior home, one they could not afford. The last stop, where Christmas may be their very last, warm knit caps and candy for the Children's Cancer Award. Merry Christmas at every place. Sure glad you could do it this year, accepting many an embrace for glad tidings, joy, and good cheer. His route now done, he answers a cell phone call. The mayor asking that he marshal the parade. Glad he heard that cell phone ring. Yes, sir. No, sir. Near about 30 years now. Not Santa, sir. No charade. Just giving, as would the king. Thank you. Thank you very much. It's my honor and it's my pleasure to introduce the Bluebillies. They don't just sing country songs, folks. They are country. Listen to the unique blend of country, bluegrass, and folk with style, with sound, and spirit. Listen to Mel, Melton, Dean, Mark, all of that Black Oak, Indiana, down-home feeling. She also dabbled in rock and roll and folk, adding Frank Orsini to the fiddle and guitarist Greg Bucking. Please make welcome the Bluebillies.
You know Dasher and Dancer and Prancer and Vixen, Comet and Cupid and Donner and Blitzen. But do you recall the most famous reindeer of all? Used to laugh and call him
Christmas time, and sometimes it's not as easy as other years, and this year is one of those years I found it hard getting into the spirit, but I started to listen to some of our old Christmas songs that Melody and I used to do a long time ago, and came up with this next one that we're going to do, and since our theme tonight is sort of a cowboy Christmas, this one got me right in the mood. It's a song that's based on the story of the three wise men and the gifts that they brought to the baby Jesus, which was gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Three very precious things in their culture. And this song is written from the point of view of Native Americans in the Southwest. And the three things that was most important to their culture was corn, water, and wood. And that's what the name of this song is, Corn, Water, and Wood. It goes like this.
Stop and behold. Thank you, guys.
I'm going to think I'm going to turn over the next song to our lovely leader here, band leader right there in the center. That's Miss Melba Dean. She's happy to be singing for you.
Yeah, it's really nice to see you all out there, I tell you. And tonight, we're sort of singing. We're singing for all the people that can't be here for one reason or another, and for my family who's out in the Midwest and they can't get over here. And we're happy this Christmas, even if we can't see everybody, we're just thinking about them, and that's a good thing. Okay, this song is Michael Martin Murphy tune. We like it a lot. Good cowboy tune called Christmas on the Line. take it.
Okay, kids. You know, my Melody loves to shop. That's, you know, you can, she's dressed as the band pretty much, and she was out the other day, and she came home with a poinsettia plant. And she came through the door, and she's, I'm going to go to dinner, bring it in bags and stuff, and she comes in with this poinsettia plant. And it's beautiful. It's got one stem, one of those little red leaves on it, kind of falling over to the side. I said, no, what in the heck is this? Why did you even buy that thing? And she said, I felt so bad for it on the shelf, I had to bring it home. And she says, and in the car, I named it Percy. So, we're going to do a song about what happened in our house this week. It's called Percy the Puny Poinsett.
Christmas songs, and this next one that he's gonna do, I think you're gonna do, yeah, this is really one of my favorites.
Well, as I was saying earlier, it's been hard to get in the mood this year. Christmas can be difficult when you can't be with the people you love, and
this has been a hard year for us. Melody and I lost our granddaughter a couple of weeks ago. And that was hard, and we didn't know how we were going to keep moving forward through this holiday. And then, just last night, we had a great granddaughter born. And she's beautiful. And suddenly there was hope again. You know, and as our son said about losing his daughter, he said, you know, every day is sad, and every day I wake up and time has moved on, and someday we're going to have moved on without her. But when Charlie came into the world, all was well. And so now we're going to do a song that I wrote 30 years ago for our kids when they were little about trying to tell the story of the birth of Jesus. And the birth of Jesus is supposed to be about renewal and hope and moving forward. So we're going to dedicate this one to Katie and to little baby Charlie, too. It goes like this.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mark. Thank you, everyone. Well, this idea of humble beginnings and even a humble existence right now is a very Christmassy type of subject. We all do our best. And so I got this song about a couple of people who are homeless and they're celebrating Christmas the best way they know how, called Christmas in Paradise. I'm in the wrong key.
Right there.
Thank you. Red ribbons and suits. guitar. But not only that, I just think it's a sweet song and one of hope, and Christmas is a time of hope. So we could all get some interest in listening to this one.
Thank you.
Christmas.